So the goal here is to build up a serial cable to connect my MITS SIOB RS-232 card to the back of the case. So I've got a little 8-pin header here that will go on the pins on the board. I've got a DB25 to go to the back of the case, crimp tool, pins, wire stripper, some reclaimed wire that I'm going to use to do this. So this should be interesting. So that wire's got a nice break in the insulation there. So really, I guess it comes down to just getting this all wired up and clean. Got a little wiring diagram here. So what pins on the DB25 connector go to what pins on the little header. The header on the board is actually 10 pins wide, but these two pins aren't used. So I'll just put it on the 8 pins that are actually used, and really only 3 of those pins are going to be used, and that is the input, the output, and the ground. So I really only need 3 leads coming into here. I think this pre-stripped end here actually has enough length to do what I need to do without cutting it down much further. Although the wires are a little bit beat up, I'll have to see if I can clean that up. So length, I need to get from someplace in the card cage to the back of the case in the machine. And that should probably be enough length there. I didn't measure this out, I'm really just eyeballing it. Of course, now becomes the fun of getting through the outer insulation here without actually damaging the wire inside. Of course, that's nowhere near cut through. Be a little more aggressive. Getting there. This is a shielded cable. So let me see if I can get the assuming it's aluminized mylar wrap off. Interesting, it's actually got an outer insulation and an inner. Of course, the chassis ground wire there, so let's get this pair here unwrapped. This is going to be operating at 9600 baud, so it's not like it's going to be a high-speed cable. Rest the end of this cable with a bit of heat shrink tubing just to make that look a little nicer. That looks like it'll size. Of course, for this we need the heat gun. Second. Apologies for the noise. Set this back out of the way. That gives me a much better dressed end here. So of course the bare wire here is the chassis. Let's see about stripping these back a bit. So black of course will be used for ground. Let me don't know what gauge the wire actually is. Nope, that stripped it well. Or maybe not. Nope, need to go down a size. Ground. Stripped one more here than I needed to. Actually, no, I'm going to be ground and two signal, and I'm not going to use the green wire for now. Soldering pencil's turned on, so I'm going to go ahead and tin these. Keep the leads from getting all frayed out here as I handle it. Got our glasses. Insulation really pulled back, continues to really pull back. Okay, that's good to know. The black didn't pull back as far as the red did. Sure why the red pulled back as far as it did. I'm going to go ahead and strip the green. Just because I'm not happy with how far back the insulation pulled back on the red. The red wire may become the unused wire here. Boy, that's really horrid how far that insulation pulled back. Well, the red in this case is not going to become the unused wire. I should have waited to put that heat shrink tubing on. I'm going to remove it, and I'm going to tuck the red wire up under it and re-shrink it. It'll be cleaner that way. Shrink tubing. The tubing I just used. That's definitely better. I am going to take, I believe, the chassis ground and the signal ground, and I'm just going to tie them together here. The chassis will be the common ground for the entire system. It's little bits of smaller shrink tubing. I can pull this off. Get that somewhat held in place. Actually, to do this right, pin one is the chassis ground. I shouldn't really tie those together on this end. Chassis ground should go into pin one there. Solder in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let me get some solder in the cup. Trim that black lead down to a little bit better size. A little bit of black shrink tubing. white. It's TSO, so we're gonna make white pin 3 here. White TSO, yep, that's pin 3 verified. Let's see if I can get that to solder up. That's the white. The green is going to become pin 2, and I don't think I have any green small diameter heat shrink tubing. Let me look. Actually, I do. Yep, almost burned myself. And the chassis ground. We'll get a little bit of black. Take solder. Shrink tubing down nice and clean. And there is the serial end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is ground. White is the 3. Green is 2, 2. And the chassis ground. So I'm just going to go ahead and cut the entire end off this, just because it's kind of gnarly and ugly. And repeat the whole thing, only with the crimp terminals. is going to get tucked again out of the way. Length here. Should have. And what becomes the interesting part is, of course, crimping. Easiest way I found to do this is to get the crimp terminal . It's always a bit of a challenge. Kind of started down into the tool. Insert the wire. And then perform the crimp. And I'm really unhappy with that. I got the wire in too deep. Let's see if I can cut it apart without damaging the wire. Yeah, I made quite a mess of this one. And I'm making it far worse here by trying to uncrimp what was just crimped. Not having a whole lot of luck holding on to it. It's too big. Thank you. bit of a mess. We will try that again. Shit, it rotated. Yep, every time I've tried to use this crimping tool, it's been frustrating. I finally do get good crimps. It's just a major pain. I'm not sure the tool I'm using is actually the correct tool for these kind of terminals, but it's what I have. Third time's a charm here. Now don't rotate. It's looking better. Not sure how good a crimp that really is. We'll have to check continuity. Well, that certainly didn't go to plan. A mangled one. This is why I bought lots. Green wire. Of course not. I touched it and the strands came on. Doggone it. It's really not an awesome crimp. not convinced I'm getting what I want here. Feel nice and tight. Check out the housing here. Which way does that go in? Goes in this way with the lock up, and then white, so let's see, what we called yellow, which became green, goes all the way down here on the end. And the white one goes in there next to the ground. Kidding me, that crimp seemed plenty tight. Every time I've tried to do this, it has been this kind of struggle. God, that even looks like a really nice crimp. Yet it really wasn't. And I'm not sure why. Oh, how many of these can I go through? I'm sure the proper tool here would make all the difference. Feels nice and tight, so I don't get why it's just slid off a minute ago. I've got that little ear poking up there, that's going to be a problem. Ground was out here at the second pin end. so, and the white would go in right next to it. Well, not the worst job ever, not the best job ever. So the real question becomes, do we have continuity? Need something to poke down in there. Of course, there's never a component lead laying around when you need one. That's going to make contact. Should come to there. Should come to here. Sense. Round white, yellow, white, TSO, came to pin 3. What became the green goes to pin 2. The chassis ground and signal ground are actually being tied together right here. That is what it is. Those are clipped in and they move freely in there. That should give me a little serial cable to go inside of the case. Pretty sweet. So with that, I will wrap this video up here and I'll see you in the next one. We'll be right back.